it down to Trickster against any pro. Only one can go into the top 16. The other will go to the up and down matches. Trickster, after such a dominating performance in his first game, losing with a really metagamed out second game. Probably going to want to play a little bit more standard here. We are going to have it on Zelnaga Fortress, our only three-player map. Haven't seen a lot of PvPs here yet.
No, we have not. Thank you for taking the intro. Joseph had to finish chewing my sandwich.
Yeah.
I needed my carbs. I needed my energy for this next PvP. You know, finished with the sandwich. Got to put it in the bag. Go back, eat a little bit more of that later in our next break here.
But look, I wish I had a sandwich.
Well, you could have told me. I would have gone by Subway sandwich and bought you a sandwich. They have vegetarian subs down there.
And I know. I love them, man. They're so good.
Now, I think we could have seen a better game from Trickster, but as our coach said, any pro didn't attack, so that Warp Prism Rush didn't exactly work out. Let's see. Is he going to do the same thing? Will he do something different? I don't know. But, you know, there's no more time because the countdown's on. Head-to-head here, any pro against Trickster, Soki Sue, Protoss against Protoss on Zelnaga Fortress here at the GSL. Let's go. Down here in the bottom left, we have our first Protoss player winning the previous match between these two. This is a rematch.
Any pro fly?
All right, now going on to our next player. In the blue, upper left side of the map. Careful, watch his dodgy eyes here. In this next shot.
TSL, Trickster.
See what I'm talking about?
Awesome. Now, before we get too much into anything, I do want to go back to that last game for a moment. I explained as much as I could think of it at the time, and something else has just hit me. If any pro actually attacks during, does his foregate and actually attacks Kisu, he's going to have a few more units, but Kisu, like, starts the base trade instantly, and he has a shuttle to get some probes out if need be.
Yeah, the also, warp prism, yeah.
Yeah, and also on top of that, if his opponent makes a mistake and warps a couple units in to try to, because he like panics and warps some units in at home, then Kisu wins the base trade. He's quicker with it.
Yeah.
So just some really interesting little tiny things about that build. Totally cool.
Well, PvP is such an interesting matchup. It's very unforgiving, as we said before. And, well, we'll see what's going to happen here. The big question for me is Soki Sue going to make four warp gates? Or is he going to make three and do strategy?
There are some three warp gate builds. For instance, Triple Stalker Rush that will stop a full warp gate build if you do it correctly.
That's when I've actually started to mess with a little bit more.
I love that build. It's like my build. People like actually counter me when I go on like U.S. servers or something. Like, well, I knew you'd do that. It's like, oh, thanks, bro. So I am super interested to see exactly what builds we're going to see here. I really do want to see Trickster do one of his more standard builds that was like so well thought out and stuff. It's like a level too high to win. You know, sometimes you outthink your opponent's such a level and then they don't do it and you're like,
yeah, like, oh. It's like when I try to do these strats where as the probe leaves, I like cancel an important structure and change it up, and it turns out they didn't even like pay attention to what I was making. They were just moving the probe around. I'm like, oh.
They didn't even click it. They like, didn't even know. They're like, no, I thought that was a robo. You're like, no, it was a Citadel.
That actually happens too.
I know, man.
They're like special builds you can only do against somebody who's like so smart that they're going to respond in a certain way.
Yep. Okay. Second gas for Kisu. Now, this could mean a couple things, but most likely it means Blink Stalker.
Yeah.
The same gas that quickly. Normally, if you're going to go for a quick robo build, no. And actually, he puts up three warp gates. He might even cancel the gas. No, he won't cancel the gas.
He might not. He just might not use it.
Yeah.
That, we can do that, too. You can just not mine from it. Even though you lost a little bit of money building it, you at least confused your opponent.
Yeah. And he's chasing any pro's probe. That's going to slow down any warp gate push that any pro can do on him. Kisu doing some great moves here. Oh, the probe did get away, though. And any pro getting his additional gas. Already, any pro starting his probe production up again. And there we go. Kisu is right after.
And he is going to use that assimilator there, so he's going to send a few more probes to mine from that. Here comes the probe. He might be able to shoot it down. And did he get vision of the four warp gates, Artosis?
No, he did not.
He did not.
He has no idea what's going on, man.
Wait, you sure you double check?
Yep. Did not.
Yeah, he does not. Wow, okay. I know we had a shout out on the screen of you guys, but I was drinking my warm water.
Yeah.
Taking care of my throat. Actually, we got like so many things on our desk right now. We have
this
my coffee,
desk at home.
Warm water. I have a thermos.
I brought in a stuffed animal.
Yeah. Got Mr. Wiggles Pop over here. Keeps me company during the cast.
Ooh, right now we have Anypro throwing up a Nexus. He's on double gas making a Nexus.
This is I guess it was a complete fake. If he makes the four gates, doesn't even use it.
Kisu getting Twilight Council. And Twilight Council going up for Anypro. Now, I want to say that Trickster has the better build here, and I feel like he's going to be able to win. Yeah, his Twilight Council is a little bit quicker. His Blink is starting. But here's the thing. Canceled the Nexus. Hold on. Okay, Kisu never saw the Nexus, and the Nexus got canceled. That's what happened when he saw all those Stalkers coming. So we're going to see Blink against Blink. The Blink of Kisu is going to be a little bit quicker. There is, as we see, Sentry for any pro. This is... This is such an interesting scenario here.
This is going to be interesting. Blink versus Blink.
Oh,
if you start to get behind in this, it's very unforgiving. Almost no way to recover.
Yeah, you really have to micro your tushy off. We do have four more probes for any pro, so that's going to make a difference in the long run. And
in other words, it's going to be up to Trickster to sort of pull through
Right now
with a victory early on. Go ahead.
Right now, he does have three more Stalkers. Same number of Zealots, one more Sentry for Anypro. Anypro is warping in some more Stalkers as we sit here. And here we go. And he chooses not to go up, sees too many. He's like, nope, that is not a good scenario for me. And Anypro takes the lead because he has more probes.
You might check in the main of Trickster. Is he chrono boosting the gateways? No, going to chrono boost the Nexus. Okay.
I like that choice. In fact, he's getting a Forge as well. Might be a little bit afraid of DTs at this point. And Anypro going to throw up his Robo. So these guys going all sorts of stuff on one base.
I would assume in this situation we'd probably want to get plus one attack if he has a Forge.
Yeah, I do like plus one attack. And he's actually getting a Dark Shrine. Kisu is getting a Dark Shrine.
Now, unfortunately, I think in this case, that means Anypro is going to be in the lead here.
Yeah.
Because he's going to have the Dark Shrine is so expensive. And then Goodney Dark Templars, it's pretty expensive.
Yeah.
So you incorporate those two things. The guy has observers.
Yeah.
He just sees it.
Well, here's the interesting thing as well. Normally, you're going to make just one observer and send it directly to his base oftentimes. If that's exactly what happens, if the DT comes at the right time, you might just kill so many probes that you win. Will his opponent spend the gas? Will he spend the 150 gas on two observers?
That
or
is
75
big question.
On one?
You know, that's a very, very good point, Artosis. One thing that all Protosses in StarCraft 2 have not adapted to yet is getting enough observers.
Yeah.
So hypothetically,
especially PvP.
If he does not, well, you know, the fear of the Colossus is so strong.
Yeah.
The people are trying to get Immortals out, get their own Colossus out.
He is.
They oftentimes neglect getting the observers.
And he's actually sitting there with one observer on his ramp. So DT, hopefully only one DT goes up with Kisu, or we could see a quick ending to this game. Kisu has spent money on a cannon at the top of his ramp. He has gotten a Nexus now.
All right, here we go.
At DT. He's not going
to
get
he
away.
He was running up there. He was like, leave it to Baal.
All right, so there's two DTs out, and that's obviously a very expensive unit. And it looks like Anypro is just going to one base here. Just one base all, and he's making some morals. Those win Blink fights so quick.
Oh, yeah.
Well, like, LOL.
One thing important to note, guys, is the animation for when the Immortal fires. It hits the target instantaneously. There's no. If you look at a Stalker, it shoots a little laser, a little pew-pew laser, and that animation has to connect with the unit, the image of the unit that's walking down there. So in Blink versus Blink battles, if it's pure Stalker, you can keep avoiding their Stalkers, blinking away, and causing their shots to miss.
Another interesting thing to know, will any pro make a second observer? Because if he doesn't, Kisu has DT, and he's just going to
exactly
run around, man.
What you were talking about with Artos. You are so right. But
and,
he leaves the observer
man.
At home.
Kisu but, right now is getting Zealot charge. That helps out immensely against Blink Stalker people who actually go for Immortals. And
he
here
just
comes.
Pulled out with the observer.
Observer on the way. Another one is on the way, and the DT is in the probe line. So Hisu right now may be able to just drop his ramp and perhaps win.
Yeah, he just needs to sack the Nexus. Yeah, just go up there.
Because he's got six kills on that Dark Templar right now. Great play by Hisu. And he's going to want to go after those probes a bit more.
Yeah, he needs to get more probes. He hasn't quite found out where the probes are.
Right now, 75 supply to 87. Hisu in the lead.
Blinks away. And he's just going to kill the Slaughter.
Slaps that thing down, man.
Okay. And, he's going to get the Nexus, but
charge is almost done. Hisu can sit on top of his ramp, pump out a ton of Zealots because he does have six gates. And, I mean, those Immortals are not going to do well against that at all. Here we go. Charge is done. He has Blink as well. He has enough for one Guardian Shield.
One more DT.
Awesome move by Hisu.
Hisu is playing this beautifully.
Yeah, he really, truly is, man. No, this is like insanity good.
And look, he's just going to get as many probes as he can.
Right now, any pro's in a hard spot. He is, man. He's trying to defend and attack at the same time, but on top of a ramp is Hisu with 1,000 charge zealots.
He can't do both of those at once. So he spotted this, but you know what? He can just make a Dark Templar and kill that Stalker.
Chase that thing away.
Well, I think any pro realizes he should have had that Observer at the ramp for a little bit longer. He should have left something back at home.
Now Kisu's going to try to run down the ramp before Force Heal comes. He does it! Now he can blink down with his Stalkers, and that's going to go pretty well for Hisu.
And it
does trap a bunch of Zealots on the high ground, but his Zealots are doing some good damage. Looks like, oh my god, does any pro have too much here? Does Hisu have to go back up the ramp?
He needs to get more of those Zealots down there, but I think the Immortals in the back here are dealing too much damage. He blinks back up there, and I think Hisu right now probably really regretted that. He does kill the Observer, though, and he can make
DTs. Yeah, he can make more DTs.
Now.
Is he making
them?
Yes,
he is.
He's
in there. Oh, man.
Now he just has to stall out, not lose too many Stalkers, because if he loses all his Stalkers, then the Stalkers can go kill all the probes.
Yeah, exactly. Kill all the probes. They keep blinking away from the DTs. This is kind of a bizarre situation.
This is the most
going to come down to unit control. He needs to make another Observer back at home, by the way, and send that up here. The Immortal is gone.
And now Kisu's starting to fight with the Stalkers because the DT's dealing so much extra damage.
Oh my god.
So interesting.
Talk about a good save there.
That was actually wild. There is another Observer coming up. Hisu may even want to make an Archon out of a couple of these DTs. He has to assume that there's going to be an Observer here. And with those charge lots, those Stalkers going to try to get away for now and take out this pylon. Going to stop any aggression for now from any pro.
I bet. I can only imagine. Hisu probably almost had a heart attack back there.
Yeah.
And then he killed that Observer and suddenly he was like, you know what? Not so bad after all.
All right, let's take a look here. 23 probes for any pro, 26 for Hisu. Supply-wise, 53 for any pro, 54 for Hisu. The thing is, any pro's army is actually better. He has 12 Stalkers against 5, and we have 3 Sentries, 3 Dark Templar, 3 Zealots for Hisu.
You know what? These guys were about to pass by each other, which means that his main's going to be completely open. And I think Kisu's going to have to turn around. He's going to try to defend his base. Now he realizes that apparently any pro assumes that the rest of Kisu's army is up there, backs up.
You know what would be an amazing move? Kisu has spent so much gas and stuff on Dark Templars that I think that any pro should go Dark Templar from here. He could expand and go DT very easily.
Not a bad idea at all.
Odds of Kisu adding a Robo right now when they're so close in units and one of them might die at any second, very, very slim.
Yeah, that's a really good observation, Artosis. Now, as you can see, the Stalkers continue to patrol around the base. Probe count here is in favor for Hisu, and we have another DT.
He's going to check out what's going on and die. Goodbye.
Man, it sounds painful to die if you're a Dark Templar.
I should have became a Stalker.
I want to be a Stalker when I grow up. Now, here comes the army.
This is weird, man.
Can he actually kill that?
The DTs, don't forget, they do deal a lot of DPS. I feel like he would be better served with them as an Archon.
Sogi City's actually just run out of here.
Yeah, I know, man. He's in trouble.
He could just blink on top of the army here. There you go. And any pro actually recovered. Sogi Sue should have stayed at home. He should have tried to expand. He should have done anything but try to attack in this situation.
Yeah, now it's 27 to 50.
16 Stalkers to 1.
Yeah, the game is over from here.
Yes.
But AnyPro is basically mined out. So is Kisu. In fact, both are mined out. Kisu actually has no money to even build any more units.
This guy is broke, man.
Yeah, that's it, man. Here come the Sockers, and he will say GG as they get there. Not happy is Kisu.
What a technical PvP we saw here. One of the most technical PvPs I've seen in a while.
Yeah, that was a wild, insanely good game. Yeah, I feel bad. I want both these guys to go on to the round of 16, and it looks like Kisu, a player that I was just speaking up so much, man, because he is so darn good and so smart.
Okay, expect GG any second. This game is over. And it looks like, despite what was going to be a comeback here, AnyPro has managed to come out as the victor. GG. Damn, man, what a PvP that was. That was actually one of the most technical PvPs we've seen.
That was
basically what was late game, end game PvP.
A wild game. And here's the thing. I feel like Kisu was so creative and cool with his play in both games, but it did not work out for him. This is the first TSL player I believe that we have eliminated.
Yeah, I think you're correct on that.
AnyPro will not be going up and down. Kisu goes up and down. I tell you, it feels like every person goes up and down match, I'm like, oh my god, up and down's getting harder and harder.
I know, man. It's actually true, too. It's getting really difficult. And that's not PvP. That's PK.
No.
I don't think it's...
Player killer?
Player kill?
I don't know.
Could be, purple coin with a K.
Purple key?
Yeah.
Pink key.
Pink key. Wow, what a game we saw there.
So,
2-1,
we have
2-0.
Yeah, in first place in this group, we're going to have Virus. Second place, AnyPro. Third place, Trickster. Fourth place, Ensnare.
Yeah.
So Trickster will have two shots to get back into Codess, while Ensnare only has one, man. That's pretty frightening. He's such a great player.
Yeah, the thought of Ensnare going down to
weird,
Code
yeah.
A, yeah. He's but like, I guess, you know, we're going to have to sort of get used to the fact that, you know, there's so many talented players here. You know, the results are so slick that, you know, as good as some of these guys are, new players are coming up and taking their spots. So, what a series we've had here. We're only halfway done with today's games. And, of course, we're going to have a 10-minute break in just a little bit here.
Yeah, and then Huck.
Yeah, that's right, man. So, on your 10-minute break, I got a little life advice for you. I want you to go through the laundry. All right, your clothes are probably dirty. I know that there's probably some nerds sitting there in underwear that's so dirty it hurts to wear. All right, I want to help that guy out. Go to the laundry, all right? You can put that in there. By the time, even if you do those, you know, long washes, you know, the ones I don't even understand what that's for in my washing machine because my Korean's not good enough. I'm like, I don't know. I'm not going to clean my clothes like that. Even if you do one of those, by the time we're done, you're going to have some nice clean clothes. So, yeah.
Yeah, it's important to do that.
It's good to be clean.
It's
so,
good to be clean.
Thank you to our sponsors.
That is some good life advice.
That's some
not
good life
lie.
Advice. So thank you to our sponsors at LG Intel and G-Skill for making this event possible. This is Code S. Although not all these players are going to stay in it, it does look like some of them are in up and down matches, which is basically your last chance to try to stay in what is basically the most prestigious individual event in StarCraft II.
Certainly.
Certainly. So do you think Huck's going to get out of the group?
I want him to
I
more than
him
you could ever know.
Yeah.
He's got such
him.
A hard
we'll
group,
see.
Man.
All right, guys. Looks like it is break time. So we'll be right back. Here, I'm Tasis. With me is Artosis. And this is going to be the GSL. See you soon.